డే స్టూడెంట్స్, వెల్కమ్ టు ఈపీజీ పాఠశాల. ఐఎమ్ డాక్టర్ టి శేషసాయి, రిటైర్డ్ అసోసియేట్ ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆఫ్ ఫిలాసఫీ, నేషనల్ కాలేజ్, తిరుచిరాపల్లి. టుడే వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డీల్ విత్ ఎ పేపర్, ఇండియన్ రిలీజియన్ అండ్ ఫిలాసఫీ, ఎస్పెషలీ ఆన్ శైవిజం. శంకర ఎస్టాబ్లిష్డ్ సిక్స్ సిస్టమ్స్, దే ఆర్ టెక్నికల్ కాల్డ్ షణ్మత: శైవం, శాక్తం, సౌరం, కుమారం, గాణపత్యం అండ్ వైష్ణవ్. సో ది ఆల్ దీస్ సిక్స్ పుట్ టుగెదర్ దే ఆర్ కాల్డ్ షణ్మతాస్. టుడే వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు సీ ది వేరియస్ టైప్స్ ఆర్ వేరియస్ స్కూల్స్ అండర్ శైవిజం. నౌ లెట్ అస్ గో టు ది ఆబ్జెక్టివ్స్ of our learning. We will start with Hinduism as a philosophy and religion. To know Shaivism, to know the different sects of Shaivism, to understand the Pashupata philosophy and its in its various aspects, Shaiva Siddhanta and its philosophy, Kashmir Shaivism, the philosophy of Shivadvaita and Vera Shaivism. Hinduism as a philosophy and religion. Hinduism is called as Sanatana Dharma because the dharma which is actually practiced by our ancestors or given to us traditionally, it is actually handed over to the posterity by our ancestors. Philosophers often do not want to refer it as a mere religion, as it permits free thinking and includes an indefinite number of customs. Generally, Hinduism is associated with a multiplicity of gods and it does not advocate the worship of a particular deity. Here, I wanted to mention that Hinduism is the only religion in the world which gives freedom to the individual. One can have his own deity. It is called in Sanskrit Ishta Devata. Suppose I want to worship Lord Krishna, I can worship. Suppose I want to worship Sri Rama, I can worship. You can choose any god of your choice. And you can even worship inanimate objects also. That is the beauty of the Hinduism. And it is the only religion which gives full freedom to the individual. It can never thrust its ideas on any individual. The most fundamental Hindu deities is the trinity of Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. The common belief of the Hindu people is that three gods rule the world: Brahma the creator, Vishnu the preserver and Shiva the destroyer. The Trimurtis are trinity. The trinity is a concept of Hinduism in which the cosmic functions of creation, maintenance and destruction are personified by the forms of Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. Shaivism. Shaivism worships Shiva as the supreme being, and the worships of Shiva is probably the oldest of Hindu tradition. The temples dedicated to him are characterized by Linga, which is symbolic of the attributes of Shiva. The characteristics of Shaivism are the exaltation of Shiva above all other gods, the highly concrete conception of the deity and the intensely personal nature of the relation between him and his devotees. The Shweta Sutra Upanishad expounds the supremacy of Shiva as the result of the theistic strain of thought developed in the Upanishads. The evolution of Shiva is found in Yajurveda, where around 100 names are given to him. These names include Pashupati or God of Animals, Nilagriva or the Blue-Necked, etc. The Mahabharata refers to 1008 names of Shiva. In Ramayana, Shiva is associated with the origin of Ganga. In Puranas, Shiva is described as Ardhanarishvara, mixture of male and female. He is also presented as a teacher of truth and as silent yogic who meditates in peace. In this position, facing south, he is known as Dakshinamurti. Dakshinamurti is one of the forms of Shiva in Shaivism, and he actually appears before the souls or his devotees to educate or to impart knowledge to all his devotees. That is the Dakshinamurti form. This is Shiva is considered as having three forms. It is, one is Nirguna, another is Guna or Saguna, another is Nirguna and Saguna. That is what they call in Tamil literature Aruvam, Uruvam, Aruva Uruvam. The Linga form is the form and formless appearance of Lord Shiva. That actually depicts the form and formless. Shiva as a dancing Lord Nataraja is another powerful representation. That is, usually we go to any temple and then worship Lord Shiva in many forms. And of all the forms, Lord Nataraja is a beautiful form which depicts the evolution. Each and every movement, each and every aspect of Lord Shiva is depicted here. That is, he is the Nataraja form, and the aura behind Nataraja, actually the aura represents the Shakti of Lord Shiva. In this Nataraja form or dancing Shiva, it is the evolution of the entire world is depicted. Development of Shaivism. The Shaivism as it is, Lord Shiva first appears in the Vedic literature, and Mohenjo-daro and Harappa revealed that the sitting posture of Lord Shiva, it is actually recognized by the scientists or the archaeologists as Pashupati, which depicts the yoga also. The first yogic posture is actually by Lord Shiva in Pashupati form. There you can see the animals and some of the human beings also sitting before him and learning the highest knowledge from Lord Shiva. The sacred literature of Shaivism is called Shaivagama, and it is placed side by side with Vedas. Kashmir Shaivam or Pratyabhijna system is monastic and idealistic. The dualistic school of Shaivism is Shaiva Siddhantism. The school, Shaiva school of Srikanta propounds qualified monism or qualified non-duality like Visishtadvaita Ramanuja. Here actually Srikanta Shivadvaita philosophy and Ramanuja's Visishtadvaita philosophy, they go side by side. Both accept qualified non-dualism as their fundamental principle of philosophy. This school of Shaivism is called Shivadvaita. Another powerful school is Veera Shaivism or Lingayata. Kashmir Shaivism, Siddhanta Shaivism, Shivadvaita and Veera Shaivism are originally based on Shaivagamas. The various schools of Shaivism is Pashupatism. The philosophical aspects of Pashupata philosophy. The Pashupatas are the oldest Shaivite tradition in the North. In them, ascetic tendencies were much evident. The term Pashupata means pertaining to Pashupati. Pashupati is the lord of Pashus. He is the lord of animals. And in the Vedic literature, Pashupati is the same as Lord Shiva. Five categories recognized by the Pashupatas include effect, cause, yoga, vidhi and moksha. God is independent, the souls are dependent. They are produced by him and are eternal products. They are called Pashus because they are fettered by bonds, Pasha. The impurity or mala defiling the souls are five folds. They are false knowledge, demerit, attachment, causality and lapse. Purity is the complete removal of these malas and means for it. It consists in observance, recitation of mantras, meditation on God, constant recollection of him and achievement of fruits. Moksha is not mere absolute negation of pain. but it is also achievement of divine sovereignty. It is proximity or samipya to God, which puts an end to rebirth. Now we come to Kashmir Shaivism. Kashmir Shaivism is advocated in the north. The fourth main system of Advaita is based on Shaivagamas or Tantras, which are accorded the same authority and status as the Vedas. Vasugupta, Sammananda, Utpaladeva, Abhinavagupta and Kshemaraja are the most eminent writers of this system, and it has voluminous literature. Kashmir Shaivism is also known as Spanda or Trika system, Shaiva Siddhanta. The chief sources of Shaiva Siddhanta are 28 Shaivagamas and hymns of the Shaiva saints. Vaikuntha Deva's Shivajnana Bhutam is the basic text of Shaiva Siddhanta. The supreme reality is called Shiva. He is referred to as Pati, which means that he is the lord of all beings. Shaiva Siddhanta accepts three ultimate realities. They are Pati, Pashu and Pasha. Pati is independent and supreme. He is the controller, he is the guide for the entire universe. Next comes Pashu, which means individual jiva in bondage. Individual jiva, though has the potency to attain mukti or to attain mukti through detachment, it actually suffers because of pasha or bonds. Pasha binds the souls, and pasha delimits the knowledge and the capacity or capabilities of the soul or Pashu. Pashu affected by the karmas, namely Anavamala, Karmamala and Mayamala. These three malas bind the pasha. Here, Shaiva Siddhanta considers Anavamala as the Moolamala, which actually inflicts the soul with I and mind. When we remove this I and mind, then the soul gets released. When the soul can get released, the soul, with the grace of the Lord Shiva, it can attain mukti. The soul, step by step or with its efforts, should come out of samsara or the vicious circle of birth and death. It should be relieved from pasha. It should be relieved from moha and ignorance. This can be done when the soul is elevated to the higher level. This higher level can be achieved by three steps: Irivinai Vappu, Mala Paripakam and Shakti Nipata. Irivinai Vappu means equipoise between the good and bad, pleasure and pain. When the soul achieves this or transcends this or masters this, Mala Paripaka comes. Mala means, as I told you earlier, Anavamala, Karmamala and Mayamala. These three malas, when they will be removed automatically when the soul or Pashu reaches that stage, that is transcending Irivinai Vappu. The last is when the soul is ready to receive the grace of Lord Shiva, that is Shakti Nipata. This Anugraha or the grace, the Arul, that is called in Tamil Arul, that descends on the soul and the soul becomes released, or the soul attains mukti. This attainment of mukti can be achieved at four levels: Charya, Kriya, Yoga and Jnana. Charya is called serving the Lord Shiva by cleansing the temples, gathering the flowers. This is called Dasa Marga, and this Dasa Marga leads to Salokya, that is living or residing in the Shiva's loka. The next is Kriya. This Kriya is a higher type of service to God. This is done with utmost faith. Here, this is compared to Satputra Marga, that is, a son doing service to God. A son is doing service to his father. Similarly, a devotee considering the Lord Shiva as his own father, he does the service. Here, it leads to Samipya. So, from Charya leads to Salokya, Kriya leads to Samipya. Next comes Yoga. Through Yoga, the mind is prone, or mind is actually tuned to attain the lotus feet of Lord Shiva through meditation, through internal organ. So this is contemplation on Lord Shiva. It is actually a Sakya Marga, they say. Sakya Marga means considering the God Shiva as his own friend. So this leads to Sarupya. This Sarupya means one can attain the Roop of Lord Shiva. One can attain the form of Shiva, but he cannot perform the functions of Shiva. That is, Tirodhana, Srishti, Siti, Laya and Anugraha. This cannot be done by any individual, though he attains the Rupa of Lord Shiva. The end, the last is Jnana Marga, where he realizes, and it is called Sanmarga. In this Sanmarga, he attains Shiva Sayujya. This is actually the essence of Seva Siddhanta philosophy. The soul gets at last mukti only with the grace of the Lord Shiva. Now, we'll see the next Shivadvaita. Sri Kanta, the exponent of Shivadvaita, adopted Brahma Sutra and not Agamas as the authoritative text to establish his theory. He interpreted the Prasthanatraya in terms of Shaivism rather than Vedanta. And here we see that Brahman has been replaced with Shiva. He was probably a contemporary of Ramanuja, and his philosophy resembles to a great extent the qualified monism of Ramanuja. Srikanta's Brahma Mimamsa Bhashya resembles Ramanuja's Sri Bhashya in many ways. In Brahma Mimamsa Bhashya, Srikanta tries to reconcile Shruti and Agamas. Brahman is called Shiva because it is full of auspicious qualities and free from taints. He is the lord of all jivas, pashus, and hence he is called Pashupati. The Supreme Lord is qualified by Shakti. It cannot exist apart from Brahman. As heat is inseparable from fire, so Shakti is inseparable from Shiva or Brahman. Shakti is different from and identical with Shiva, the energizer. The causation is transformation or parinama. It is a transformation of Chit Shakti, which is non-different from Brahman. Srikanta does not believe in the creation or origination of pashus or individual souls from Shiva or Brahman. The Jiva has co-status but not identity with Brahman. Srikanta holds that the embodiment of Shiva, despite the co-status with Brahman, is due to some beginningless transgression on the part of Jiva. He points out that Jiva is soiled by beginningless ajnana or anava, karma and mayamalas. So the entire Shaivism depends on these trimalas, anava, karma, mayamala. And this mayamala is the, anavamala is the root cause which kindles karmamaya, karmamala and mayamala. He recognizes four malas, anava, karma, maya and rodha. Srikanta takes that Jiva is atomic in size but is encased in a linga sarira constituted of the seeds of his future body. He transmigrates to another species with his linga sarira. Like a lamp illuminating a room of any size, that this atomic Jiva enlivens all the body irrespective of its size. Lord conceals the true nature of the Jiva and entangles it in bondage. He removes the veil and grants its release. Bondage and release depend upon his will. Srikanta strongly recommends the path of bhakti. When Shiva becomes pleased, all the malas or bondage is restored by his grace. So, whether it is Srikanta or Pasipata or Saiva Siddhanta or any other kinds of or school of Saivism, they stress this grace as the ultimate, and without grace, any soul can never attain mukti. Next, we come to Veerasaivism. Veerasaivism is said to have been emerged in Karnataka region to curtail the significance of Jainism. Veerasaivism or Lingayata Mata gained momentum during the beginning of the 12th century and was based on 28 Saivagamas. The term Veerasaivism means a staunch follower of Saivism. It consists of the worship of Shiva in the Shivalinga form only. There are two views among the Veerasaivism as to the founders of their sect. According to one view, it was founded by five ascetics or teachers, saints, namely Ravana Siddha, Marula Siddha, Eko Rama, Panditaradhya, Vishwaradhya. They are believed to have been born out of Shivalingas. The other view regarded Basava as the founder of Veerasaivism. When we look into the history of Saiva literature, we can find the picture which you see on the right side of the content. He is Basava, who is the founder of the Veerasaivism. He broke from traditional Hinduism and vehemently protested against meaningless rituals by refusing to undergo the sacred thread ceremony. He advocated equality of status to women, abolition of caste system, dignity of labor, and such other advanced views in those days. Basava, in fact, is a revolutionary in as far as a religion is concerned in our country. He is a vehement or staunch advocate of the non-ritualistic tendencies of our society. A systematic presentation of Veerasaiva philosophy is found in Sripati Pandita Srikara Bhashya, a commentary on Brahma Sutra. It is a synthesis of Vedas, Upanishads and Agamas. And this Bhashya is like a wish-yielding tree to moksha seeking Saivas. Like the other Saiva sects, Veerasaivas also regard Shiva as the supreme principle who controls both Pashu and Pasha. Lord is the cause of the world and world is the effect. The Lord extends the universe at the time of creation and withdraws it within at the time of Pralaya. He held that the world is real and eternal. The supreme Shiva is independent and his body is not karmika. Jivas are seen to experience miseries, etc., due to their beginningless karma, karma mala. Shiva removes this and absorbs the jiva within him. Veerasaivism believes that it is only due to Shiva's grace that one can get liberated. It has prescribed diksha or initiation into Shaiva's spiritual path as the condition precedent for all aspirants to moksha. Sripati asserts that the knowledge of about God and one gets released from all bonds. By realization, one attains the supreme Shiva Tattva. He holds that even by bhakti or devotion to Shiva, one can achieve four types of liberation like Saloka, Samipa, Sarupa and Sayujya, which is called Salokata, Samipata, Sarupata and Sayujyata. He recognizes the Jivan Mukti concept of liberation and says that Jivan Mukta realizes that Shiva is in everything. After the fall of his body or death, he loses his individuality and merges into or become identical with Shiva. To summarize, the Shanmatas are Saivam, Shaktam, Sauram, Kaumaram, Ganapatyam and Vaishnavism. Among these, Saivism has got many schools and the schools are Pashupata, started by Nakulisha, Veerasaivism. The founder of Veerasaivism is Basava. Saiva Siddhanta from Tamil Nadu. Kashmir Saivism, otherwise called Pratyabhijna School. All these philosophies or all these schools of Saivism, they advocate that there are three ultimate realities: Pati, Pashu and Pasha. Pati is the supreme, Pati is the independent being. Pati is the creator of this universe, he is the sustainer of the universe, he is the destroyer of the universe, he is the one who bestows anugraha or the grace to the individual souls, and he, with his concealment nature or the tirodhana shakti, he educates all his devotees or the individual souls. All the schools of philosophies, they accept three malas, that is Anavamala, Karmamala and Mayamala. Shivadvaita adds one more, that is Rodhamala. These malas, they actually limit the infinite into finite, they cause ignorance to the soul, and the soul suffers because of these three malas, and in samsara it suffers. To get release from this samsara, one should always meditate, or one should, almost all schools, they prefer bhakti, and with bhakti they should chant, they should always continuously chant the names of Shiva or Nama Sankirtana, what we can call. And this Nama Sankirtana leads to mukti. The best way is to utter or chant the Ashtakshari by the Vishishtadvaita school, which is called Om Namo Narayanaya, and for Saivism it is Om Namah Shivaya. This Om Namah Shivaya is the only mantra which leads the individual soul to attain mukti. Almost all saints have uttered this, chanted this, remembering constantly the grace of the Lord and remembering the names of the Lord, and attained mukti. This Namah Shivaya contains five letters: Na, Ma, Shi, Va, Ya. Na means the Tirodhana Shakti of Shiva, Ma means the three malas, Shi means Shiva or the man who is the independent supreme authority, Va means the grace part of the grace Shakti of the Lord Shiva, and Ya means the Jiva. The Shiva stands in between Na, Ma and Vaya. So Shiva descends, Shiva's grace descends on the individual soul to remove the three malas, and the individual soul gets mukti. This is the importance of this Panchakshari mantra. And they also, almost all teachers of Saivism, they stress the importance of Guru. Without Guru, nobody can reach or nobody can think of the attainment of moksha. And this Guru also selects and gives his instructions according to the capacities or according to the capabilities of the individual soul. Then he initiates. In Veerasaivism, the initiation of the Guru is stressed. The Saiva Siddhanta stresses the same thing, and almost all Saiva schools stresses the importance of Guru and stresses the importance of initiation into the path of bhakti or into the path of meditation to attain mukti. There are several types of diksha. One such is Naina Diksha, where the Guru sees the Shishya, then he attains Mukti. This is just like a fish, the mother fish sees the eggs, immediately the small fishes will come out. Next is Parsha or Sparsha Diksha. This Sparsha Diksha, by touch of the Guru, the disciple attains Moksha. That is, the third one is Vachaka Diksha. The fourth is Yoga Diksha. The fifth is Diksha by Shastras. All these five Dikshas or these Dikshas will lead the disciple to attain Mukti. This will lead to Mukti by the grace of the Lord Shiva. All these individual souls attain Mukti. At last, this individual soul gets Shiva Sayujya. For further reference, please refer to e-text. Thank you.